Okay people, in this video we're going to be having a little more in-detailed look at a MK Commando 63 amp plug. Okay. That is not it, okay. That is not it either. Oh, there it is. MK Commando 63 amp plug. Proper sized one that. The rubber bung is just loosely sat on the top. Okay. So, we are going to be having a little more in detailed look at that plug. Not those two. That's this 32 amp one. That's out of here. Bye bye. And that's the 16 amp one. Cheerio. So we're left with that one. And we're going to be opening it up carefully in this video. There's that rubber bung sit next to it. And unlike these ones where it's the, you put the thing in there, give it a twist, and these parts twist to open. That one, you've actually got screws holding it together. Okay, let's see if I can get a zoom on those screws, but you know what this camera's like for zoom, people. There they are. Gonna get another one? Probably, but it's not, let's not take chances with that zoom. Okay, four screws, there's two there, and if I turn it around, there's the third one, and there's the fourth one. I've already loosened four of them off. Four? Three of them. There's the fourth one. And taking a suitably sized screwdriver, I'm going to open that up carefully. And we shall have a look inside this 63 amp MK Commando plug. Okay, it is blue coloured, which indicates 200 to 250 volts. Single phase. Okay. Like I was saying with this one, it's not the, you push it on and twist it, lock it. You've got the four screws, and that just lifts up like so once you've loosened those screws off. So let's move that out of the way. And let's zoom that out. You can see brass inserts in that. Okay, so this is proper top quality industrial plug. Okay. Let's zoom that camera out. And sticking up on the top there, straight away we can see a cord clamp. Okay, because that's where all the action is, I'm going to be looking at that in a minute or so. Let's have a look at this. There you go, nothing special in there to look at. That's why I wanted to get that out of the way first. Because, you know, there's nothing special in there. What I will say on this, though, is I do believe that on the IP67 variant of that plug, instead of having the rubber bung in the end of there, there is actually an additional fitment which goes into that thread. Now, there is a thread in there. Let's zoom on it. There you go. Oh, is that it? That's about it. You can clearly see that there's a thread inside there. Okay. There's a thread on that rubber bung as well. You've actually got to screw that in. Okay, screw that in. Getting it back out is a different ball game though. You've actually got to basically get your finger down the side of there, pull and tug it until it comes out. You can screw it in, but you can't get them back out again. So yes, I do believe that on the IP67 variant of that plug, there is actually an additional fitment which screws into there. And that lip down there will have a washer in there, so when you screw that in, it does make the plug IP67 category. Okay, this one's an IP44, which means it's only splash proof. Okay, similarly, that part there, it mates up inside that down there. And once again, on the IP67 one, I do believe there will be a washer inside there. so that when that presses into there, you get that watertight seal, that all-important watertight seal. Okay, let's put that back on. There's a little notch just there. You've got to meet that up with that there. Okay, where is it? There. Okay, that little notch just there goes in there. You can't put this on any old how. Okay, so let's meet that up now. Like that, okay? So when you take that off, that inner section goes inside there, like that, okay? You get the idea. But on the IP67 ones, I do believe there will be a sealing washer all the way around inside there. And also, one thing that this doesn't have on it, because it is the IP441, is the large locking ring around it. So when you put that in the socket, you tighten that up, and that will once again have another sealing washer on it to provide the requirements of IP67. So we've looked in there. Nothing special in there. There's the rubber bung. Just plop that in there. There we go, we know where that is. Once again, we've got one of those quick and easy to release cord clamps. Okay, it got a bit shaky then because I was pulling the camera back. And the little rubber feet on the tripod sort of shake a bit, and it makes the camera picture go all a bit off. So we've got one of those easy to release cord clamps on that. Pull that out like that, and pull that out like so, and it comes off. Okay. Next up, we're going to be looking at the terminals in there. Now, this is a single phase one, but it does have four terminals on it. Right up the top there, we've got the earth terminal. Then we've got the live terminal there. And neutral one there, okay? That's all plain sailing so far. But the difference with the 63 amp one, unlike the 16 and 32, is you've got a little pilot contact there, okay? And what that is for, basically, if you had 63 amps whacking through that plug and you whipped it out of the socket, it wouldn't half go off with a bit of a bang. So you've got a little pilot contact in there, and you can see that that is physically shorter than the rest of them. Okay. Now, although these earth one and the neutral and the live look the same length, what actually makes the earth join before neutral and live is the tubes inside the socket. Okay, the tubes for the neutral and live will be recessed quite far back inside the socket, but the earth one is more or less straight at the front. Okay, with the little pilot contact being that short, it obviously, when you put in the plug in, it obviously makes connection last, but it also disconnects first when you pull the plug out. That pilot contact is used for when the socket is electrically interlocked, okay? With the socket that I've got, we'll have a look at that a little bit later in this video. It is mechanically interlocked, so you won't need to worry about wiring up that pilot contact, okay? For an electrically interlocked socket, what it does is when you put the plug in, you get a small, I'm not sure which direction it goes in because I've never wired one of these before, but you get a small electrical current go down, either go down that pilot contact or come out of it. And that goes back to basically a contactor inside the socket. And when you put the plug in, earth makes contact first, then the neutral and live at the same time. as soon as that little pilot contact joins, the contactor clunks in and turns the power on. Okay? And also, because it is that short, as soon as you whip that plug out, it gets out a certain way, and then the pilot contact loses connection, at which point the contactor drops out and disconnects the power. Okay, like I was saying, yeah, whip that out while there's 63 amps going through it, and it wouldn't half go off a bit of a bang. It will probably severely damage the plug and the tubes inside the socket, which have got to hug those pins. Okay, and I want my bet, and there'll be quite a flash as well. So there we go. Okay, that's what the pilot contact does. It's for electrically interlocked sockets. So, a little bit later on, in another video, I will be wiring that up. There's the cord clamp. That goes on there. I'm going to put that back on. Like that. Goes in one side. And you clip it inside the other, like that, and then you lift it up. Once it's in the raised position like that, you cannot remove that, because if you look at that, the holes are elongated, as is those on there. You can put them in and out easily while it's in the lowered position, okay? But once you put that up, that then you can't get that out. Will not come out, okay? There it is for 12 minutes. MK Commando 63 amp IP44 plug. Inserting the rubber bung. I'm going to put that in there now. Give it a twist. It's got the thread on it, of course. Got to line the threads up. And in she goes, I believe. Oh, no, we've gone a bit cross-threaded again. There we go. I think it's established the thread. Oh, maybe it hasn't. You'll be amazed how difficult it is to get a threaded rubber bung in there. There we go. I think that's taken now. There we go. There it is. But I'm telling you one thing, people. Once you've screwed that in there, you can't get it back out. The only way you can get that back out is to basically get your finger inside there and pull at that and to pull it downwards like that and hook it out that way. So you go, that's in there, I believe. It is actually starting to bind up a bit. It should go in more than that, but I can't get it to go in. Maybe if I push it, it will actually go over the threads. Yeah, it's going over the threads, so I can actually, there we go. That's right properly in there now. Okay. Like I say, on the IP67 variant, instead of having that rubber bung in there, you would have something else which screws in there. And that would then, it would provide the IP67 category. Okay, so you can see that in there. Okay. Put that back together. Again, remember that little notch I was saying about just there. I've got that zoom on. No zoom. I keep forgetting how big this pluggy really is. Let's find our little notch. There it is. Okay. So we make sure the little notches line up. And that should go together like that. I'm only going to be doing up one of the fixing screws which holds the front and back sections together. There we go. That will be adequate for the following demonstration, which is about to come up in this video. There it is, over the back there. MK Commando 63 amp plug. I'm just going to move that over a bit because here comes the socket. What I've got here, it is part number, it's an MK It's a part number K9355. Okay. Mechanically interlocked switched sockets. There we go. Like I've already said in another video, you can't turn that switch on while there's no plug in there. And similarly, when the plug is in and the switch is turned on, you cannot withdraw the plug until you turn the switch off. I've done another video on that socket, and if you want really sort of in detailed video of that socket, look in the video description and there will be a link to that socket, and we have a little play around with it. I'll jig it and poke it and goodness knows what else, and go into all the details of how that is mechanically interlocked. Okay, so I'm going to get the plug, put it in there, and away we go. Okay, so I'm just going to lower that camera down a bit, or should I lower it, raise it up? I'm going to raise it up. Okay, there we go, it's at top height now. And so if I just bring that socket over, I'm going to light it down so that the socket is up in the air. Again, this is the IP67 one because it's got the large locking ring on it. This one is going to be used outside in the garden, hence it being the IP67. Okay. Under certain conditions, you can install the IP44 ones outdoors, but they do need to be in a partly sheltered position and not used anywhere near strong jets of water. Okay, like say for example, if you was going to put it in a place where it's going to be frequently exposed to the possible risk of getting hit by a jet washer, you install the IP67. Okay, and then if you do accidentally get it with a jet washer, the IP67 socket will take it, whereas the IP44 version won't. To open, rotate the ring and that lifts up. There we go, there's the socket. Earth down the bottom because it is a 6-hour socket. You got your neutron in live, and then up the top there we got our pilot contact. Okay, not used on this socket because it is mechanically interlocked instead of electrically interlocked. There's our plug over the back there. It is a bit of a challenge to get that plug in there because it's a right old proper sized plug. Big boy's plug. And there it is. There we go. Off. Let's lie that down. Okay, it's not going to lie down properly because the length of that plug. Okay, so I'm going to hang it over the edge of the worktop. I'm going to have to get off my seat for this. Right, let me just set everything up. You can have a look at that little teddy bear for the meanwhile. Okay, I'm going to have to just partly overhang it over the worktop, because if I hang the whole plug over, the plug and the socket will fall on the floor. And that little assembly that you were just about to see up in front of the camera there, it is particularly expensive. Like I was saying before, I walked away from the camera, I just said that it's particularly expensive, and I think we've already established that in other videos. Okay, right, let's turn this camera around then. There's the 63 amp plug and sockets right there. You can see that the plug has got a downward angle to it. Okay, so there we go, 63 amp plug and sockets. Okay, the socket is mechanically interlocked, and there we go. In another video, I'm going to be wiring that 63 amp plug. Okay, So yeah, do stay tuned for that, and thanks for watching, people.